You've probably been on a bus or some other moving vehicle at some point, right? Ever gotten stuck standing up on a bus, clinging to one of those poles, hanging on for your dear life? Crazy question. What if you were to let go of that pole and jump? What would happen, aside from annoying your fellow busgoers, of course? Let's think. While in the air, your body would not be in any direct contact with the bus, so there's no way that the bus could affect what happens to you. Your intuition may tell you that the bus is no longer moving you forward. So, you would, in a sense, stop moving forward, and the back of the bus would crash into you. However unpleasant this obviously seems, it makes sense that it would happen. Except, it doesn't. If you're brave enough and actually do jump on a moving bus, as long as it's moving in a straight line at constant speed, you'll notice that something completely different happens. You land back on the same spot of the bus floor from which you left. Well, that's kind of weird. The bus floor moved forward during your jump. The bus couldn't have pushed you forward while in the air, and yet you still landed in a different spot above the ground? Well, that's just what physicists call inertia, the tendency for an object to maintain its state of motion. All this means is that when an object isn't being pushed or pulled, it continues flying in whatever direction it was going. To paraphrase my high school physics teacher, staying at one speed is just the default. Nothing really causes you to continue moving. You just continue moving because nothing is stopping you. Now let's imagine another scenario. What if you jumped on a moving bus with all the windows sealed shut? As long as the bus doesn't turn a corner, go over a bump, or change its speed, if you jumped, it would just seem like the bus wasn't moving at all. In fact, if you tried to do any physical experiment inside this isolated cabin, none of them could tell you that you were moving, even if a friend on the sidewalk could clearly tell you so. By the way, this friend of yours is always late for the bus. In the time your friend is waiting for the next ride, he has some time to kill, so you tell him to verify the experiments you did on the bus. Surprisingly, he reports the same results that you got. Whether it's your friend at the bus stop or you on a moving bus, the same thing happens. So who is really standing still? Of course it must be your friend on the ground. He can tell you with the utmost confidence that you're the one who's really moving. Although, you're clever. You can just tell your friend that you're in an equivalent situation and he's the one moving. But this is just childish, right? Although we all can't help but refute our friend's hypotheses just to prove him wrong, we know it deep down that your friend is probably right. It must really be your friend who's standing still. He's on the ground after all. And how can the ground move? It's the ground. But wait, isn't that ground beneath your feet spinning around the Earth at over 300 meters every second? And isn't the Earth orbiting around the Sun at around 30 kilometers per second? And isn't the Sun moving around the center of the Milky Way at over 200 kilometers per second? And yet not you, nor your friend, even notice that you're both moving so fast. Is it even possible to figure out who's standing still at all? The surprising fact is that no, there is nothing you can do to convince everybody, regardless of their state of motion, that you are really the one who is standing still. All you can say is, hey, every experiment I do makes it look like I'm standing still, regardless if someone else disagrees. If you can say this, you are in what physicists call an inertial frame of reference. All this means is that everything around you seems to behave like you are not moving. In this case, you and your friend are both in your own unique inertial frames of reference. You could each claim the other is moving, but in your own frames, you're each standing still. In fact, anyone moving in a straight line with constant speed is in their own unique frame of reference. In each frame, you can treat everything as if you're at rest, even though someone else may disagree. But after some thought, we can't be ones to disagree. We're willing to appreciate that all is the same no matter what side you take, being on the bus or on foot. Both you and your friend are right. You are each standing still in your own way. It just depends on your point of view. Just one last thing though. Don't actually jump while on a moving bus. Real buses turn, start, and stop continuously, which would cause an unfortunate accident.